We're very thankful that they were able to bring this helicopter to us here today. And it's just going to be a couple of moments here before we get the Cyclone into the sky. Just want to make sure that our Hornets and our Polaris are clear of the display area. And we're also going to get our clearance from our air boss, Eric O'Connor. Call sign home, doing a great job controlling all of our traffic here today as the CH-148 takes to the sky. Time helicopter, your Sikorsky CH-148 Cyclone. Today is Captain Alex Chetwin. He is the pilot in command. He's from St. Albert, Alberta. He's a former Sea King pilot and part of the Vanguard team, the initial cadre trained on the new CH-148 Cyclone. His co-pilot today is Captain Brandon Philp from Alberta, part of the Cyclone Fleet's ab initio cadre. He's thrilled to be returning to his hometown air show to perform for you today. Tactical officer is Captain John Jacob from Maple Ridge, British Columbia. He had a ground deployment with Air Task Force Iraq before converting to Cyclone Aircrew. And the sensor operator today is Master Corporal Sean Lathion from Halifax, Nova Scotia. He was a former Navy diver before transferring to the Maritime Helicopter Fleet. Submarine warfare, the CH-148 Cyclone is also called upon to perform surface surveillance. Internationally, the CH-148 has been involved in multiple deployments with NATO around Europe and deployments throughout the Pacific in support of the UN and other organizations. The CH-148 has also participated in international exercises such as RIMPAC, Joint Warrior, and Trident Juncture. It's also provided support in Newfoundland during the 2020 snowstorm and Opelentis during the 2021 floods in British Columbia, as well as continuous support for disaster relief. The CH-148 has a maximum weight of 29,300 pounds and is powered by two 27 horsepower turbo shaft engines. It is capable of carrying 6,000 pounds on its cargo hook and has a range of nearly 700 kilometers. Now, folks, I want you to take a close look at the underside of this helicopter as they fly by, because the Cyclone has several powerful sensors. On the underside is where the camera, radar, radio antennas, and cargo hooks are mounted. The camera at the front allows the crew to see long distances, day or night, while the radar, mounted in the large gray dome, can detect objects at great distances. As the Cyclone comes to a hover here, folks, he's going to demonstrate for us the search and rescue side of the helicopter's capabilities. Right now, John Jacobs is being attached to the hoist in that door on the side of the helicopter, and in just a few moments, he's going to be hoisted down towards the ground. Just imagine with me, if you will, that there is a boat in distress. Of course, the conditions are not as calm as what we would have here. The seas are high and roiling, the winds are high, and it's the job of the pilot to make sure that that helicopter stays in the exact same spot as they hoist John Jacobs down to our boat in distress. There he is, folks, just hanging there on the prop wash of the helicopter, being lowered down towards the ground. Give him a wave there, folks. That's John Jacob waving for you from the hoist of the Cyclone there. I think he's doing a little bit of a dance, trying to swim up the hoist. And slowly but surely, he's going to be hoisted back into the helicopter. We'll just imagine that they have been able to attend to the victims on our boat in distress. And they would probably attach some of the folks to the hoist and bring them into the safety of the helicopter. That hoist can carry 600 pounds, and it's about 250 feet long. This allows crews to hoist from altitudes much higher than you see here today. Can carry 6 passengers, but can be equipped to carry up to 22 passengers when needed. Cyclone's fly-by-wire system helps the pilots maintain that steady hover that you saw, even hovering the helicopter automatically if the situation requires it. The system also allows the crew member operating the hoist to adjust the position of the helicopter to ensure it's exactly over the survivor or the boat in distress. Now, we always talk about boats here, but the Cyclone could be called away to help hikers who have gotten lost as well. So we really appreciate all the hard work of our Royal Canadian Air Force personnel who work so hard in very, very dangerous conditions to keep us safe and to rescue us when we get ourselves into a little bit of trouble. Okay, here's a high-speed pass, this time from the right in the Cyclone. As they go by there, folks, the CH-148 Cyclone. That's right, wave your hands, wave your hats, wave your three-year-old, heck, wave your grandma. They can see you. Okay, put grandma down now. What an incredible demonstration from going from high speed to slow speed, so that you can touch down right there at show center by our crew of the Cyclone. If you'd like to meet today's Cyclone crew, then head over to the autograph booth. The air crew and technicians will be around for the next few minutes after they get the helicopter taxied into the static display area. and get it shut down. In just a few moments, you'll see that. And you'll have an opportunity to get a close-up look at this helicopter as well. Just make sure you don't ask too many questions, because there is also a lot of top-secret type equipment on this helicopter. I got the distinctive, I can't answer that, kind of response from John Jacobs when I was talking to him about the helicopter's capability the other day. But they're happy to talk about whatever they can.